Hey everyone, it's Maya Flagpie and I'm back to show you a day in my life. This past week I've been working the Big Ten men's basketball tournament and today was the championship. The final showdown between Illinois and Wisconsin took place at 2:30 p.m. at the Target Center in Minneapolis, but I made sure to get there about an hour and a half early. With 15 minutes until gameplay, both teams were on the court for shoot around. I was talking to my coworker Tremont on the left right there on who we thought was going to win, and he said Illinois and I said Wisconsin. My mom's from Wisconsin, I was born in Illinois, so honestly I would have been happy with either team winning. They loved playing this song every game, but it does go hard for a warm-up. This is Illinois' Terrence Shannon Jr. He got 40 points last night against Nebraska in the semifinal, and he became the all-time leading scorer in the Big Ten men's basketball tournament.
Oh, say can you
I was so shook. She can sing.
What so proudly we
This was a fun segment throughout the tournament where they would ask players questions such as, what's your coach's favorite movie?
Happy Gilmore. I don't know what you watch. I can't be as bad.
The Illinois players run out for game time and Wisconsin was doing the same on the other side. The Big Ten showed a recap of how the Badgers and Illinois made it to the championship. Illinois is called the Fighting Illini, but they didn't have a mascot. I did some research on the Fighting Illini and found out it's based on a fictional American Indian figure and the NCAA deemed it as hostile and abusive. Bucky the Badger is so fun. Before the game, he made sure to blow my camera a kiss. I noticed this is something Shannon Jr. does before every game. There wasn't enough seating on the court, so I started watching from the media room. I made my way back to the court to go watch from the auxiliary seating. This is just a higher up seating for the overflow when there's a lot of media. During the women's tournament, I was always able to find court seating, but during the men's, I noticed there was a lot more coverage. They show Big Ten Players of the Week, and Zach Edey was actually Big Ten Player of the Year. He averaged 24.4 points a game. Also, look at the score, 16-16. This game was down to the wire. Ooh, shout out Gophers, Cam Christie, Dawson Garcia. Marcus Damask is so quick on offense. Backflips are so cool. Shout out to the band and cheer team, they work hard. During a timeout, we honored Army veterans. Moments like these are so heartwarming.
US Army. Subway sub for lunch, like, every day. I would go to Chipotle every game, like, probably like three, four hours before the game.
That's game day, not game day. I'm broke here. Need to find Subway somewhere here probably too, so.
They showed the Ohio State fan mascot, and I was like, what are you doing here? But I love his spirit. I wasn't allowed to put out live media of the game, so I made sure to just tweet out any information I saw, as well as think of questions to ask during the press conference. Also was able to ask questions to players in the locker room. The Target Center was packed with Wisconsin fans as it's right next door to Minnesota, so it was definitely a home game for the Badgers. Luke is just walking on over to the refs to figure out what that foul was about. On Instagram, I saw many comments from basketball fans saying the refs were always trying to help out Wisconsin throughout this tournament. What are your guys' thoughts? When I'm analyzing a game, I like to follow along on statbroadcast.com, and this is free for anyone to use. Big Ten asked players what it means to represent their school.
So it means a lot, just being, you know, feeling love and then being a part of a, you know, rich history of, you know, a program like Illinois. It just means a lot to me.
Hey, go cheer team. Go cheer team. This Illinois fan was a real one. Being surrounded by Badger fans, it can be hard to cheer, but she made sure her voice was heard. This is me doing a hair check, because you already know how it is with curly hair, me putting on some Aquaphor, this giant bottle. Started to film a lot of content on this cool camcorder, and the footage is fire. Photo shoot, shh, pose. Sorry, y'all, it's the model in me. As the half comes to a close, as you can see, Illinois leads 41-40. These two are a dynamic duo. They're so, so quick on offense. It's almost unstoppable. That's a wrap on the first half. During halftime, I like to look over my notes, look at stats, look at any highlights, and just do a halftime brief. This halftime show was impressive. I feel like I've seen him on America's Got Talent, but I'm not sure. It started to make me nervous, so I got up and made my way towards the court. I wanted to make sure to get down to the court at least a few minutes before the second half started in order to film the Badgers' entrance. Some behind the scenes action. I'm going to be at that Big Ten desk one day. This is what the tunnel looks like when the Badgers ran out. As you can see, the refs are coming out. Who's gonna win? Well, y'all already know, if you're a basketball fan.
This AI thing is creepy.
Shout out to Big Ten, they know how to treat their media. I got my popcorn and I'm ready to enjoy the second half. This is a cute little notebook that my mom gave me where I like to write down my game notes, stats, and just any questions I'm gonna ask during the press conference. They asked Illinois about any superstitions they may have.
Yeah, I try to keep everything the same. same food. I played well with the same food. I ate that food, and I'm eating that food for the game.
This was a smart question to ask in order to get to know the player's personality. The Badgers came out with determination as they were dominating the start of the second half, leading by 10.
Whoa!
Chucky Hepburn is such a smart player. This next clip I'm about to show was so funny. I'm so mad I didn't get the full thing on video, but they were showing Max's TikTok and how he likes to dance.
I got everything. Like, my bag is really deep. Like, I can really tap in and dance.
Okay, camera work. Okay, angles. I've had to do a handheld camera for hockey, and it's hard. It's 72-70 now, and Illinois is winning. You never really know how a basketball game is going to turn out until that final buzzer. During this time, I voted for who I thought the most outstanding player was in the all-tournament team. I love the fan cams because it's pure enjoyment. I've been on the camera side of this, and it's so fun picking out people to get on the video board. With about 1 minute left, Illinois leads 88-85. After this missed shot, the Badgers needed a miracle. Illinois knew they were about to win the big championship. Like Coach Brad Underwood said, this team is so connected. Seeing so much joy is so heartwarming. Hard work always pays off. And this team had a tough battle throughout this whole tournament and came out on top.
Are giving us a great championship game. Now to present the congratulations to the 2024 Big Ten Men's Basketball Tournament Champions, the University of Illinois.
Thank you.
He won Most Outstanding Player of the Tournament, voted by media. I know I'm a part of it, but looking at all the media taking photos and videos is so wild. The song choice made me want to float. I love Stevie Wonder. Making my way towards the media room and locker room so I can ask the players and coaches questions. Got my traditional player pick with Coleman Hawkins. Players had to go into the VIP room for Selection Sunday, which was exciting to watch at the Target Center. I forgot to give you guys a fit check, so here I am posing. My favorite thing to do. The last time Illinois men's basketball won a championship for the Big Ten tournament was in 2021. My favorite part is coming up, press conference time.
Hi, Maya Flackpy with Gopher Hole. Coleman, I saw you signing autographs of the fans. How important is that to you to take time to talk to fans?
Yeah, that's really important to me because, you know, they spent their time, their money to come out here and come support us. And, you know, I've always been that little kid and wanting to get an autograph from college or NBA players. And I just don't want to be the guy to blow them off. So obviously it was a timely thing. And obviously if I had more time, I would have stayed out there and interacted with more fans. But that definitely means a lot to me.
Question in the back.
I'm so proud of myself for asking questions during these press conferences. It's so important to me to bring exciting questions to these conferences. I'm finishing up eating the salad and pizza that was given to media. I noticed fellow reporter Marcus was in my shot. He reports for Star Tribune, and he's an awesome mentor to have. They're taking down the background for the press conferences. Very bittersweet moment, as this is my last day working a Big Ten tournament. This was such an amazing experience, and journalism never feels like work to me. I'm so passionate about working in this field, and I can't wait to see what the future holds. Grab some waters that they gave the media, because this water was actually so good. Heels check! My dad picked me up, and we were on our way home. Shout out to my dad for being one of my number one supporters and always taking me to work. He also might be one of One Direction's number one supporters, as he's always listening to their albums. Thank you so much for watching, and subscribe to my channel for more day in the life content.